When we talk about whiskies, we can't really afford to make a lot of mistakes because we know it's particularly a drink that you should have good knowledge about. But how much do we really know about its making process? Is it similar to other liquors? Are single malt and blended whiskies made in the same way? Well, we know there are a ton of questions in your head, but don't worry. In this video, we're gonna answer all the questions you have about the making of whiskey. Hi and welcome to a brand new video of How It's Made on Alcohol, and today we're gonna tell you all about how whiskey is made. When making whiskey, the production varies depending upon the style being made, the country where it originates, and some other factors. But the general process remains the same in most cases. The first step of this process being malting. All whiskies start as raw grain, and in the case of malt whiskey, barley is specially treated in order to access its sugars. The barley grains are moistened and allowed to partially sprout or germinate. A process called malting then takes place that secretes an enzyme that converts the barley starch into sugar. Mashing. The sugars contained in the grain must then be extracted before fermentation, and this is done through the process of mashing. The grains that are being used, like corn, wheat or rye, are then ground up, that is put in a large vat with hot water and agitated. Even if the distiller is not making a malt whiskey, some amount of ground malted barley is typically added to catalyze the conversion of starch to sugar. Once as much sugar as possible has been extracted, the mixture left behind is called mash or wort, and this is what moves on to the next fermentation stage. Fermentation occurs when the mash or the wort meets yeast, which gobbles up all the sugar in the liquid and converts it to alcohol. This takes place in large vats, often known as washbacks. The process can take anywhere from 48 to 96 hours, with different fermentation times and yeast strains resulting in a diverse spectrum of flavors. Distillation. The process of distillation increases the alcohol content in the liquid and brings out volatile components, both good and bad. Stills are usually made of copper, which help to strip out the unwanted flavor and aroma compounds. The two most common type of stills, which are pot stills and column stills, actually function quite differently. So pot stills are usually used to produce malt whiskies, and they follow the batch process. While some styles are double distilled, some others are distilled three times. Column stills, on the other hand, are used to produce bourbon, rye and other grain whiskey and follow a continuous distillation process. A column still works continuously and efficiently, eliminating the need for the batch process of pot stills. The next step is maturation. Nearly all whiskies are aged in wooden, usually oak barrels. One notable exception though is corn whiskey, which is aged for a really short period of time or left unaged. Bourbon, rye and other types of American whiskey must be aged in new charred oak barrels. As for the other style, the types of oak and its previous use are usually left to the producer. When making blended whiskey, different malt whiskies or even malt and grain whiskies of the master distiller's choice are mixed together and left to marry in these huge barrels. Bottling. Once matured, the whiskey is then bottled at a minimum 40% ABV. This is then chill filtered or filtered another way to prevent it from getting cloudy when cold water or ice is added. For most large whiskey brands, a bottling run combines several barrels of whiskey, which could be anywhere from a few dozen to a few hundred from the distillery's warehouses. When only one barrel is bottled at a time, these are labeled as single cask or single barrel whiskies. So this was our video on how whiskey is made, and I hope we made it a knowledgeable and fun watch for you. So if you enjoyed the video, make sure you hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe to Alcohol and follow us on Instagram to stay in tune with all the happenings from the world of alcohol. Until next time, drink responsibly.